Thank you, Venkat.
Can you hear me okay? I know there are issues with the mics. Okay. Great topic to follow on from talking about verification quality to what I'm going to talk about. Great keynote earlier. It's time to move beyond data science simple models. Like previous speakers talked about, last touch attribution, simple identity. You know, we have a data too. We have third-party data, cute identity, and building models on top of that. It's time to move beyond that. Before I talk a little bit, let me. I've been in the data space for a long time. Been at data product companies where we're spelling billions of dollars worth of data across the industry for 10 years. But I've been at large organizations where I've been buying a lot of data. Most recently at Walmart as a chief data officer, prior to that at Capital One, leading the data and analytics teams there, buying north of hundreds of millions of dollars worth of third-party data and testing and verifying and calling BS when we got stuck with some data, right? I've been there, done that in terms of any vendor, you name it, I bought data from them and try to verify and try to understand and try to figure out where it is. And last year I joined Neustar. Having seen all of this, coming to a company that's smaller than the size of my team previously, right? It really, for me, what large organizations that have the data spend and the power and the be able to, the dollars to be able to verify and build things, right? What are they able to do? How do we bring that to the broader audience? How do we create all this FUD that's out there in the market about we have identity too, we have a graph, we have a cross-device graph, we have a beautiful address graph that gives us the location, and we have identity. And these are the reasons why, so much of the fraud, it tees up to a lot of the conversations that we just had, from the gentleman here. We need to move beyond all of this and really understand what is the next big trend in the next decade. Everything is being connected. Everything is connected to all the products that you see, the shoes, to any product that you see, they're all connected. And with these connections across products and services, online and offline, being able to create a simulated online environment, even in the physical stores, everything is connected and you have a digital exhaust and a footprint that's coming up along with all of this. This creates great opportunities, but you need to understand the power of the connection. With all of these things being connected, you need to understand the power of the connection. Connection fundamentally changes the nature of any object. If you just see an object, then really look at it's connected, new business models get enabled, and it creates unprecedented opportunities. But there are challenges. More connections means more data means more complexity, and as such, more risk. You've seen last year and continues to happen, the challenges that come in with the explosion of the connected devices, the security challenges that come in, your DVR and your devices that are connected acting for the enemy, right? Trying to create a lot of security challenges and wreak havoc across the system, with all of the DVRs and all of the connected devices being bugged, by the enemies, right? So, now more than ever, we need to focus on how to connect people, places, and things through authoritative data. And our mission at Neustar, being here in the businesses that we operate in, we are here to help grow on the marketing side and guard, protect the businesses using our authoritative identity that connects people, places, and things. And to understand this connection, you need to understand identity. And if you are in the market for identity and if you are in the market for data, I've been on the other side, you know, everybody has that. Everybody has that data. Everybody knows it's people-based marketing and people-based data, and I have a people, and I have, this thing. But do they have the trusted identity? Do we know what's on the other end of every connection? Can you verify it? Do you have authoritative identity? How do you get that? Now, as we talk about this authoritative identity, we want to tee up this concept called connection science. Before you build your beautiful models on data that is not authoritative, everything else will be wrong. If you get identity wrong, everything else that you do with your models, everything will be wrong. So, what we mean by this, because of the businesses that we operate in the communications, in the network security, and applying data science, we have correlated, corroborated, and really created this graph of people, places, and things to really make sure we pull the authoritative identity together. There's conversations before, I've seen some static 1.5 billion links removed or something. That's great. It would be good to not have those links in the first place, right? So you have a lot of these vendors out there that have a lot of beautiful graphs, a lot of beautiful identity. This becomes the bedrock of everything that you do. And because of the beautiful data exhaust that comes from the businesses that we operate in real time, not your typical batch data vendor provider that's from the 90s, right? This is 2017. We know that identity is not static. You really get identity, say, you got it, few months ago, few years ago, it changes. It's not static, it's very dynamic. You see some of the stats there, how many people move, the phone numbers that change, the devices that we flip now, everything changes. So you got to be on top of the game if you need to get the identity right, and you need to have the right partner. Of course, it's just not about people. The location intelligence, the places, and the data around the places, and how we bring this together. Of course, devices. We're all talking about how many devices there are, the explosion of devices, and what that's causing. Now, to make sense of this world, you need to have an authoritative lens, a lens on your customer that connects people, places, and things. Now, every large company that I worked for, like Walmart, Capital, of course, any brand, you have a lot of this data. You have a lot of this data for your first-party customers. But is that connected? Do you know how to connect it? Do you know how to corroborate it with external authoritative identity? For you to be successful, you need to have this authoritative identity that connects people, places, and things. And build your decisions, build your analytics, build your attribution analytics, build your beautiful metrics, not the useless metrics that were talked before, but build all your metrics on top of that, all things come together. But if you get the identity wrong, like we discussed before, everything else. So now, Neustar, we're a trusted provider for government, identity for government and finance, top banks, top card issuers, all the communications companies. We are in the real time, in the connections, understanding who is on the other end of every connection. As a result, we can bring in authoritative identity, being able to corroborate devices, locations, and people, and bring that data that acts as the bedrock of everything else that you do on top of it. This 1ID system that we call this ID graph that we create, the Neustar 1ID system, fuels all of the solutions that we actually provide. And it's just beyond marketing. We're obviously in risk and fraud, based on the other conversations that happened just now. Fraud and risk is a big area, it's like even for marketers to think through. And The communication solutions and security solutions that we're in gives us the license to create this authoritative data set, creates this beautiful data exhaust for the products that we build, for the better, deeper understanding of the people, places, things that puts this all together. Now, this comes from over 300 sources, corroborated sources, that are continually organized in the graph at the real time with people, places, and things. And for each one of you, what is important is to be able to understand your customer graph. Nowadays, the paths that customer takes are not linear. Gone are the days where you can say last touch attribution and, you know, I have a simple model that works, you know, I have an identity that works. What you need to know is your own customer graph across people, places, and things that is infused with the broader industry data. You operate on top of that. You have the broader people, places, things graph, infuse your first party data, and you have the customer graph that will help you deepen the understanding of the customer, centered around the customer, not around a cookie, not around an email ID. Great, you know, it's like people that still think a cookie or a mobile ad ID or an email, beautiful, all of those things are cute by themselves, but that's not identity. You really need to pull all of this together in your customer graph that is powered by an authoritative identity. That becomes a foundation on top of anything you do. And obviously, there are large organizations that spend more than $500 million in data that do this in-house. But there are the rest of us, we need somebody to partner with, need to look at all the first-party data that you have through this lens, through a connected customer lens, and the connected customer graph. And just to throw some numbers out there, over 45 billion in real-time inquiries every day. These are not batch files going up and back, you know, to say I had identity of, you know, last month, or I had a cookie ID a month ago, right? 45 billion daily inquiries, 11 billion updates, and you can see on, obviously, others have discussed the importance of third-party data. Yes, we have that too. We have over 16,000 attributes and all the things that can decorate the inventory much better and describe who is on the other end. But if you really get the identity of who is on the other end of the connection wrong, it doesn't matter what's the breadth of the attributes that you have. What really matters is the identity. And, you know, to me, I want to end with three key takeaways. Identity is not static. You need your own customer graph. For you to have that customer graph, you need to look at just not people dimension, not just not people attributes, across people, across places, and across things. And move beyond marketing. You know, what you're doing, you know, some of you, what you're doing, are you are at the forefront of connecting digital and offline. You are at the forefront of connecting, understanding, deeper understanding of the customer. You're at the forefront of creating metrics, understanding the customer journeys, and optimizing the customer experience. You know, we talked earlier about, it's not, you know, Gary gave a great speech about, it's just not about how many clicks, all these metrics. It's about ultimately, does the customer experience? It's about, does your prospect love the brand? How do you really understand that? To understand that deep understanding of the customer, I suggest you need to connect all the relevant data across the devices, across locations, across people, and bring all of that together and build everything that is on the bedrock of that. And when you do this for your marketing purpose, it will serve the entire enterprise well. It will serve the entire enterprise well. And obviously, you need your customer graph. So thank you. We're excited to be here. We're here around, and I'd love to chat a little bit more about this conversation. And I say the connection science, which is about correlating, resolving, entity resolving, corroborating the amount of data that is thrown at today's scale, billions and billions, you know, every hour of data that's coming in, being able to correlate, corroborate, and then verify using an authoritative identity is going to be the big trend in the next 12 months. With that, I'll close. Thank you very much for listening. We're here.